Stop wasting time fumbling in your workspace, dragging clips around, or looking for that one offline clip you forgot where you moved it to. Make sure you spend your time in the creative process of editing. So let's have a look at 5 tips to edit faster in Premiere Pro. Hey folks, Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to the Creative Videography channel. We share all kinds of tips to make creative videos, so make sure you're spending most of your time in that creative process too. So that's why we've gathered 5 great tips to dramatically increase your editing speed. The first tip is kind of obvious but still often forgotten, and that is to work with shortcuts. Certain keystrokes that will perform a specific action or even multiple actions at once. In Premiere Pro, we can go to Edit from the menu and select Keyboard Shortcuts. From here, you can see the different short keys and its allocated action. You can also change or remap the shortcuts here, and what really makes your personal workflow faster is if you set some custom short keys. Think about certain actions you perform a lot. For me, that's enabling or disabling the video output to my second screen. It's a setting from the menu Preferences Playback, so I'll search for Playback in my Shortcuts option window and set a custom keystroke for it. If you'd like to learn more on how short keys can speed up your workflow, then make sure to follow the video link in the card up there. But before you do so, let's first take a look at the 4 other tips we have for you. Tip number 2, find a workflow and organize it. There's no best editing workflow, as it's something personal. Premiere Pro has many windows or panels which you can resize, rearrange, add or close. Remove the panels you don't need so you'll have a clean workspace. I'm, for example, not using the History, Media Library and Info, so why keep them there? And since I have a secondary monitor, I like to increase my timeline so that I can work with more layers. Sometimes I make a selection of a large edit, which after I again make a selection from. I adjust my workspace so I see the 2 timelines on top of each other. I can now easily drag clips from one timeline to another. From the window menu, you can then save your custom workspaces to recall them later. You can create different workspaces for different tasks or adjust the default spaces from Premiere. Assembly, editing, color corrections, effects editing, audio mixing, and more. If you have the Workspaces panel active, you can easily switch between these, making switching and your specific editing tasks a lot faster. And this brings me to tip number 3, organize your files. And that starts on your computer. Create a folder with your project name. In this folder, we'll put everything. The clips we've shot goes into a subfolder called Footage, the music and sound effects in the subfolder Audio, and all the rest goes into the Assets folder. When I then create the Premiere Pro project, I also make sure it's saved within that folder. Next, I drag everything in Premiere and I make sure that I keep the same hierarchy. Organizing everything might cost a little time, but it saves you a ton in the future. And with having everything in one folder, I don't have to be afraid of moving certain files around. I can put the entire folder on a USB stick and give it to a colleague. And I'm 100% sure that he's got all the files. Now, before we dive into tip number 4, let's first take a look at our sponsor who makes these videos possible. Rocket Stock extensive set of 120 light leaks are a great way to give your video a sense of organic elegance. These 4K ambient overlays and transitions come in 3 distinct styles: modern, vintage, and sci-fi. So whatever your look in your video requires, you can achieve it with these epic light leaks. Get it back via the link in the description below. Welcome back, folks. The performance of your computer will of course also deal a lot with the editing speed. If your computer isn't that fast, then there are a couple of tricks to speed things up. The first one is to work with proxies. These are lower resolution clips of your original shots, which you can make your edit with. Once your montage is complete, you can then swap them back with the original clips. We've made a dedicated video that shows you exactly how to do that in Premiere Pro. Just click in the card up there again. Another way to improve your performance is by going into the Premiere Pro settings from the menu Edit, Preferences, Memory. Here you can choose how much computer memory Premiere Pro can use. By giving less memory to other applications, Premiere Pro is able to use more, thus creating its performance. But be aware though that other applications might run slower because of this. And lastly is a very simple trick if you're working with multiple layers. Perhaps there are certain layers you don't constantly need to see. For example, in this project I have myself a green kit and placed before a digital background. For the editing of this project, I don't need to see the background, so I can disable the output of that channel by clicking the toggle track output button on the left. This will play back your edit a lot faster. And then the last tip for today is to work with templates or presets. I know, we all like to be unique and original, but using pre-made styles does speed up your work process. You can also make your own templates or presets to reuse whatever you've created. We've also done that for our green key setting. Every time we've shot something in a studio, I can just drag my preset to it in Premiere Pro. It does the keying for me, the masking, and the color correction. Simply select the effect you'd like to store, right-click on it and say Save Preset. Give it a name and press OK. The preset is now stored in your effects library from which you can now drag and drop it to any clip. If you'd like to learn more about working with such presets, then again you can click on the cards up there and that will bring you to another video from us. You can find a quick summary about these tips and all the links I talked about in the description below. If you liked it, please share it with your friends and make sure to subscribe to see tons of more tips and tricks every week. Thank you so much for watching and stay creative.